All you have to do is open the newest beekeeping equipment catalog and you'll realize that there are so many tools and supplies and pieces of equipment that are in beekeeping. You know, there's all of the stuff associated with the hive, the lids, the frames, the foundation, etc. There's all the stuff associated with extracting and processing honey. There's also all of these little tools and trinkets that you may not know what they are. I'm going to use this episode to tell you some of the favorite tools of the trade that I like to use around the apiary, and I'm really going to split it into two halves. I'm going to split it into a half that includes everything that I always take with me to an apiary every time, and that, of course, that's in addition to my personal protective equipment, and then I'm going to do the second half showing you all the things that I like to have on hand back at the shop in the event that I need them because they're really handy tools. So first things first, let's take a look at what I carry with me into the field every time. These are the items I don't go into the apiary without. And of course you'll recognize most of these things, but I'll tell you why I like to have them with me on hand. First of all, the smoker. You should not keep bees or go into a beehive without a smoker lit. A smoker is an essential tool, as is the hive tool. Hive tools are necessary for prying apart the boxes, removing the frames because bees glue everything in the nest together, using propolis. So the hive tool is necessary to help us take those boxes apart, remove the lids, take out the frames, etc. To me, these are the two most essential tools that you'll take with you into the apiary. Of course, there's different designs of smokers. There's different designs of hive tools, but these things aside, they should accompany you every time in the field. Another thing that I don't leave without would be a tack hammer, and then of course the accompanying nails. Now you might ask yourself, why would I carry a tack hammer and nails with me into the field? Well, working bees is difficult. Removing frames and placing them back into the hive can cause significant frame stress. So at some point, you're going to pull a frame apart, pull the top bar off, remove the ends, etc. And having a tack hammer and nails on hand, framing nails specifically, allows you in the field to put those frames back together if it's necessary. I also really like to have a bee brush that helps me move bees off of areas where I don't want them, maybe the face of a comb, maybe the top of a box. But a bee brush is one of those handy things to have along with you everywhere you go. And the next set of equipment that I keep with me when I go into the field essentially is queen handling equipment. I carry queen cages with me in the event that I need to find a queen and store her temporarily while I work a hive. For whatever reason, I tend to find these things are very useful to have on hand because I am always coming up with a reason to have to catch a queen, maybe move her between two hives. It matters not to me what style of cage you use, but something to capture the queen and hold on to her for whatever reason is a useful thing to have. The next group of queen-related items all deal with clipping and marking queens. In this particular case, I use this small pair of scissors to clip queens' wings. One of the neat things about these is they're really small and you can have them with you wherever you go. In my case, I like to purchase those little pocket knives that will hang on a keychain, and therefore I always have queen scissors with me because they come with scissors that you can use, like what you see here. So I either carry one of these into the field or one of these into the field so that I can clip a queen's wing as needed. For those of you who are uncomfortable grabbing and holding a queen while you clip her wings and while you mark her thorax, you might consider having some sort of queen collection device. This one captures the queen from the surface of the comb. This one is similar in the event that you put the cage here, coerce the queen into it, and then you can plunge the queen to the surface of this where you can mark her easily. So how is it that I get all of this into the field? Well, I carry everything in a metal bucket. Why a metal bucket? Well, smokers get really hot, and if you put them into a 5-gallon bucket so that you can hold everything together, you risk melting the bucket. So I like to keep my smoker in a metal bucket, and I have all of these tools kind of loosely around in that bucket as well. I am very careful to ensure that anything that could melt, perhaps the plastic stuff or the bristles of the brush, don't contact the smoker wall. But certainly the things that are metal can go in the bucket with the smoker, and I have them on hand every time I need them. Now, there are other pieces of equipment that I like to use in my beekeeping operation. They don't always necessarily go into the field with me, but there's some things that I think are worth discussing so that you may find them valuable in your beekeeping operation. I'll start with some of the things that handle frames in the box. For example, This is a frame grip. It comes in many different styles, and a lot of new beekeepers struggle when they're using their hive tool to get the frame out. They struggle with understanding how best to remove that frame. So they will pop those frames loose with a hive tool. They'll use a frame grip, which is simply two pieces of metal that are spring loaded that when you squeeze together, it grips. You can easily use these to remove the frames in your hive. And now you've got it. You can look with one hand at both sides of the frame pretty easily, and you can return it to the hive body. So frame grips are nice to have. I haven't used one in a very long time, but a lot of folks really enjoy using them. Another thing that deals with frames are what we call frame spacers. Now there's really two types of frame spacers. One type nails into your box on the inside lip where the frames would normally rest. It nails there, and like the name implies, it holds the frames an exclusive distance from the next frame. It spaces the frames equally, and that helps you maintain bee space in the nest. Well, they also sell these manual frame spacers that when you return the frames to the nest, you can use this frame spacer to put the frames back in place. This one here happens to be an 8-frame spacer. They make 9-frame spacers as well. And again, you can use these to perfectly space your frames in the nest. So a frame grip, a frame spacer, and the third piece of equipment that goes with a frame is a frame cleaner. This shows up on a lot of beekeeping equipment tests. Most people fail at not having a clue what this is. It's a strange looking thing. It's got this handle. It's got this crooked neck. And when you turn it this way, you can see it's got this piece of metal with a sharp tip on it. It's called a frame cleaner. So guess what it does? Well, it's used to clean frames. If you have a reason to replace the comb that's in the frame and you push out that comb, bees will have built wax and use propolis in a lot of the cracks and crevices around that frame. So you can use the frame cleaner to scrape out those places and make the frame ready to receive wax foundation again. So that crooked offset neck allows you to do it from outside the frame. You can scrape a lot of the propolis and wax off. A little known piece of equipment, but one secret is I actually keep this in my smoker bucket every time I go out to the apiary, even though I've probably hardly ever used it. It's a nice little piece of trivia. It can be very useful, and a lot of people find them useful. There is a fourth piece of equipment I really enjoy using with frames, and it's called a frame holder. And this piece of equipment actually accompanies me into the field every time I go and work my bees. Frame holders, or frame rest as they're more appropriately called, clip onto the wall of the box. They extend with two metal pieces from the wall of the box so that when you are working your box and take out a frame, you can hang it on that frame rest while you work the rest of the box. And that gives you a frames space gap in your box that you can work your bees and manipulate frames. Let me tell you about a few other pieces of equipment that I really enjoy and end up using quite a bit in beekeeping. One of those is simply a spacer. Now, what function does this serve? If you see, I've applied it on top of this box, and what it does is it creates extra space above the frames in this box. For people who like to administer pollen patties to their colonies, putting on this spacer here will raise the upper box off of that pollen patty, give you plenty of space to administer that pollen patty. Bees have equal access to that patty all around so they can protect it from small hive beetles. There are some treatments that you can put in colonies that require that extra space, and just having this on hand is quite nice. You can build a few of these, keep it in your shop, but they'll be available for you for use later. So I've rearranged this table to focus specifically on a couple of items that I like, items that help you move honeybee colonies. And honestly, the first thing I'm going to talk about is one of my favorite cheats in the beekeeping world, and that's the ratchet strap. You can buy ratchet straps from almost any hardware store around. And I love these things for many, many, many reasons, but probably the way I use these most is to secure single hives for the purpose of moving them. So the old way of assembling hives together such that they wouldn't fall apart while they're being transported was to take metal staples and staple the boxes together, staple the box to the bottom board, occasionally staple the top box to the lid. And those are great ways to keep those parts of a hive from shifting in transport, but they also require a lot of work. You have to nail in all of those staples. Once you get the hive where you want it to be, you have to remove them so that you can work the colony within it. And that is the power of the ratchet strap. In this particular hive, I've already ratchet strapped this hive's components together. This thing is nearly indestructible at this point. I have literally carried these hives before ratchet strapped, where my partner would drop the hive and the hive would flip upside down and I was left looking at a hive completely upside down, but it was 100% okay. It didn't come apart, and that's all thanks to the ratchet strap. So I love having these things on hand. I don't necessarily take them in the field with me every time I go work bees, but I definitely have a lot of these back at my shop because I use them all the time in beekeeping, especially to secure hive parts together for the move. And that is why I like the ratchet strap so much. Such a handy tool to have and to use in your beekeeping operation. Now, of course, one of the things that happens in the beekeeping world is you have to move hives every once in a while, either to chase honey flows or to chase pollination contracts, etc. And you can move hives with your hands. You and a partner can pick up a hive, one in the front, one in the back, one on one side, one on the other, and move it to where you want it to go. But hives are cumbersome. Yes, they're cubes, and it looks like they should be easy to move, but they can be quite heavy. Of course, commercial beekeepers have conquered this because they keep their hives on pallets and they're able to use forklifts and other type equipment to move their bees. But for most beekeepers, the hobbyist and the sideliner, the beehive, even if it's strapped, represents a very awkward thing to have to move. And that's why I like this piece of equipment, which is just the hive lift or a hive carrier. It's a really simple device. It's designed for two individuals to simultaneously lift and move the hive. And the key lies right here in this piece of metal that comes off of this bar. It comes off on both sides. I've seen hive lifters with this metal. I've also seen hive lifters or carriers that have that big piece of rubber here. In the case of this metal, or if it were rubber, they fit under the front and the back handles of the hive. And that allows the hive to be lifted. So I'm going to take this one. You thread it over the top of the hive, like so. So what happens is one piece of metal fits in the first hand grip, the last piece of metal fits in the back hand grip, and then an individual can stand on either side of this hive and lift and carry it where it needs to go. I've used hive carriers or hive lifts so many times that it's really impossible for me to count, but I've enjoyed using them every time, and they've made carrying these cumbersome hives a really simple task. So there you have it, a few of my favorite beekeeping items that aren't related to personal protective equipment or pieces of the hive. I like these things, they help me keep bees better and make it a little bit easier to keep bees in the field. Give it a try and see if you like it. I hope you enjoy them as much as I do.